Welcome to another episode of Talking with Docs.
I'm Dr. Paul Zalzal.
And I'm Dr. Brad Weening. On today's episode of Tricky Tuesday, Paul, what did you do today?
Nothing tricky.
Nothing straight, super
it was,
tricky.
It was straightforward Tuesday.
Straightforward Tuesdays. What did you do?
Well, I had a scope.
Okay, so what is a scope? You mean knee arthroscopy?
I did knee arthroscopy on someone. So that's where you have an internal derangement of the knee, and we put in a camera and some instruments and try and deal with it.
Okay, well, why don't we start by looking at some of the footage of the scope, and then we'll talk about what the deal is later.
It's very brief. It's a very brief little video of in the OR. Thank you to our patient for consenting for me to video that.
Okay.
Let's take a quick peek at it.
Okay, Paul, here we are. What are we looking at?
We're looking at the knee. I've got the scope in the knee. Thigh bone on the top, shin on the bottom, and there, up to the camera. What do you see there? You see on the
little
screen.
Little tear right at the back, so that white horseshoe-shaped structure is torn right there.
Meniscal tear.
Perfect. Okay, so that was really interesting. So you fill the knee up with salt water,
yeah.
Put the camera inside, and then you can look all around rather than having to make a big cut like we used to do 40 years ago.
That's right. It's arthroscopy, so we can look inside the knee. Now, the question that a lot of people have in the office, they come in and they wonder,
yes,
do I need a knee scope?
Okay, so why don't we talk about maybe the top five reasons that people would require this procedure?
Yeah, now this is an evolving thing because maybe 10 years ago we used to scope knees all the time.
Especially for arthritis, just wash them out.
Yeah, wash out or scrape
them
up. Come in. But that's changed.
Certainly has changed. And a lot of the literature, actually very specifically, one study is commonly quoted in like the newspapers and people say, scopes don't work anymore.
Right, so the pendulum sort of swung the other way, and when the media got a hold of some of the studies, some of the studies said, look, maybe we shouldn't be scoping all these knees, it's not helping.
Right.
The media got a hold of it, and then people at home watching TV or on the internet say, oh my God, scopes don't work at all.
So for everyone, the take-home message from that study and from the newspaper really is that if your knee is severely arthritic and you need a knee replacement, then you shouldn't have your knee scoped.
Yeah.
But for our purposes today, the top five reasons that you would need a knee arthroscopy would be...
Number one, I would say an acute traumatic meniscal tear. So you tear that shock absorber in your knee, the meniscus. Let's say you're a 25-year-old athlete, you did a twisting maneuver or something, you tore that meniscus, and it's symptomatic. You're having mechanical symptoms, catching, locking, giving way. You've tried physio, you've tried non-operative things, the knee's still bugging you.
Yep.
I think then it's reasonable to get that knee scoped.
Okay, that's a good one. I'd say a loose body. So when we talk about loose bodies, it's usually a loose piece of either torn meniscus that's actually broken away from the meniscus, or articular cartilage, or even a piece of bone, like an osteophyte that forms in response to arthritis, that now is floating around almost like a kernel of corn that can be irritating. So that'd
yes.
be number two.
Irritating, that's the key. So it's a symptomatic loose body, a loose body in the knee that's causing symptoms.
Yes.
And yes, arthroscopy can help. Actually, we can take out that thing, and your symptoms such as locking, getting stuck, sudden shooting pains, that
yep.
might go away if they were caused by that loose body. Good.
Okay, number three.
Number three, I would say a septic arthritis or an infection. You've got an acute infection inside your knee, and that is treated with arthroscopy because we go in, wash it out, and get rid of the infection. You can take antibiotics all you want,
yep.
but if you have an infection collection in a closed area like a knee, we have to scope it to wash it out and get rid of the infection.
Yeah, there's just too many bacteria for antibiotics to work, so you got to reduce the bacterial load and then give them antibiotics afterwards. Okay, so that's number three. So number four, I would consider a diffuse synovitis, or when the whole lining of the knee is grossly irritated to remove. This is a pretty uncommon reason, actually, but it's one that is successful for that very specific group of people that has irritating lining of their knee.
Okay, that's
number
good.
Five.
I would say what we call a locked knee. So you have some sort of internal derangement. It could be an ACL tear, or it could be a meniscus flipped into the joint,
yep.
or something that's going on in your knee that's locked it, and you can't get it out straight. You're missing about 20 or 30 or 40 degrees of extension. Your knee's locked because of a mechanical block.
And that actually becomes an indication for more urgent arthroscopy. This is
yep.
not something that can wait 2 or 3 months where some of the other procedures probably could.
Yep.
This is something that's more emergent because the way that the ends of the bones are putting pressure on each other can cause degradation of the cartilage.
Was that five? Did we say five?
I think that was
so
five.
So that's our top five. There's other reasons, like you get your ACL reconstructed.
Yep.
Or when we do high tibial osteotomies, we scope the knee.
Every now and then you'll scope a stiff total knee replacement, which
yeah.
is a tricky procedure, but sometimes yeah. that's done.
Yeah. yeah.
Or a foreign body, if you had like a nail go in your knee or something like that,
sure.
sometimes you got to go looking.
Sure. So there's some other ones. We just wanted to narrow it down to five because everything's always top five. All right. So when should you not get your knee scoped?
So I think if you have advanced arthritis and you need a knee replacement, that's probably number one for me. Yes. And that's most commonly when people say, hey, can we just scope my knee? And I'm like, well, physically we could scope your knee. It just wouldn't make you any better.
It won't help. You've got an arthritic, inflamed, upset knee. The last thing it wants is someone to put a camera and some instruments in there. It's just going to get more inflamed and more upset.
Yep.
So things like going for a scraping, that doesn't exist anymore. Go in for a cleanup. That doesn't work. There's no such thing for that. Those are not indications for arthroscopy. There's other things we didn't mention, like if you have like cartilage lesions and you need like the cartilage fixed, you can have that done. There's some newer techniques with cartilage transplants.
Yep.
Sure, arthroscopy is good for those, but not for like a diffusely arthritic knee that's on its way to a knee replacement. That the scope probably won't help. I mean, the placebo effect might help.
Sure, 30%.
So what if you have some arthritis and you have a meniscal tear, okay?
So I tell my patients it depends on the kind of the chronicity and severity and the character of your symptoms. So if you have like sharp stabbing pain that's very focal, that's more likely to be related to a torn meniscus. Whereas if you have dull aching pain like a toothache, I tell people there's a lower chance that arthroscopy would be beneficial there.
Yeah, certainly our literature is suggesting that if you have a bunch of arthritis and a meniscal tear, then the scope's probably not gonna help you. I tell patients, you know, if I see, they say, oh, but I have a meniscal tear, and I notice they have a bunch of arthritis, I say, Jimmy crack corn in regards to the meniscal tear, because your new diagnosis now is arthritis.
Yep.
Don't worry about that meniscal tear. The meniscal tear is part of the arthritic process. So that's how it can get confusing. Because so people say, well, you said meniscal tear is your scope.
Right.
But in the presence of a bunch of arthritis, you probably do have a meniscal tear.
Yes. Agreed.
There you go.
Well, thanks for watching. If you like it, please like it on YouTube and subscribe to our channel.
And remember, you are in charge of your own health.
See you next time.